Genius Kids. Cultivating love for learning.
Lesson 9. Land, soil and water resources. Knowledge acquisition. We have already read about the natural resources in the previous chapter. Land, soil and water are important natural environmental conditions such as different elements of weather and climate, hydrological cycle, weathering of rock, etc. Land resource. Land is the most important natural resource as human beings live on it and obtain most of their needs from it. It is used by human beings for settlement, agriculture, transport, and other activities. Even most of our clothing requirements come from land. About 95% of human food requirements are met from land. Land covers about 29% of the total surface area of the earth. Entire human population of more than 7 billion people today live on land. Out of that, 90% people live on 30% of the land area. The remaining 10% also live on land but in hostile terrain like deserts, mountains, grasslands and in extremely cold areas. The areas are thinly populated. Land use. We use land for different purposes like cultivation, grazing, mining, setting up of industries, settlements and so on. Such land utilization is called land use. The proportion of land put to a particular use and its distribution over an area or the world is known as land use pattern. For example, agriculture, housing and roads. Differences in land use also depend on environmental problems and cultural differences of the people. Physical features of the land also put certain limits to its use. Major land use patterns of the world are 1. Forests, 2. Arable land, 3. Pasture land grasslands, 4. Rough grazing, 5. Wasteland, 6. Savanna, 7. Mining, fishing and industrial centers. Factors influencing land use pattern. 1. Population growth is the major factor that determines land use pattern as well as its changes, for example conversion of forest land into crop land, etc. 2. Physical factors like topography, climate, availability of water, soil and its fertility. 3. Occurrence of mineral deposits favor mining and also invite human settlement, transport, etc. 4. Crop combination and nature of soil determine land under agriculture. 5. Technology plays an important role in determining land use for various settlements. For example, human settlements near the high seismic zones are usually avoided. Land use in selected countries of the world. From the given table, we can draw many important inferences. For example, India has a very high percentage of arable land, 57%. Australia and UK have more land under pasture. Japan has 67% of its total land area under forests. Canada, which has a good percentage of its land area under forests, has put its land area to other uses. The above land use pattern also depicts probable economic activities of the people. For example, agriculture is the dominant occupation of the people in India. Two European countries, France and UK, have a sizable portion of arable land and agricultural occupations are still very important. Activity. Study the bar graph of land use by continents and the table of land use in selected countries and answer the following question. 1. What is the major land use of the world? 2. Name the countries having the highest percentage of land under crops. 3. Establish a link between land use and economic development. Common property resources. On the basis of its use, land can be divided into private lands, community lands, and cooperative ownership. Traditionally, Adivasis in India and Tiavanbiales in other parts of the world consider land a community resource. In Africa, even today, many communities use pasture lands as a common resource for grazing their domesticated animals. They even collect fodder, fruit, medicinal herbs for community use. Community lands are considered as a common property resource. This concept has been extended to corporate lands under globalization. Many corporate companies have established industrial parks as a common property resource. However, the ownership of the land continues to be privately owned by members or shareholders of the company concerned. World pattern of land use. The world pattern of land use is shown on the map below. It may be observed that both climate and relief factors determine land use pattern. In major parts of the world, people still practice nomadic herding and primitive agriculture, whereas in developed parts of the world, people practice commercial agriculture to get the maximum benefits from land. We should prepare a plan of land use. Land use planning. The conservation of land resources takes into account the needs of the community as well that of environment, including technological development. Therefore, for this purpose, some hindrances like regionalism and disturbances in occupational structure of the people need to be overcome. Soil resources. Soil is an important resource which sustains the living world. It is the top covering of the Earth's surface. It comprises of mineral particles and decayed organic material which together help plant growth. The organic content in soil called humus. Soil profile. In the process of weathering, rocks break down and alteration of minerals takes place on or near the surface of the earth. For weathering to take place must be in equilibrium and in contact with the atmosphere. Soil is formed in a layers from parent rock upward. This layering arrangement is called soil profile. The layers of soil are also called horizon. Generally, there are three horizons designated as A, B and C. C is the bedrock, B is the subsoil above it, and A is the soil proper and contains humus. Soil formation. Soil formation is a slow and complex process. It takes thousands of years to form a very thin layers. Plants, animals, insects and countless bacteria besides providing materials for the formations of humus are also useful when they are alive. They sit the soil and provide open spaces within soil to take in air, oxygen, nitrogen and carbon dioxide. Bacteria convert atmospheric nitrogen into usable forms. Temperature, precipitation and other chemical constituents of soil also help in soil formation. Thus, soil is formed by mechanical, chemical and biological processes. Factors affecting soil formation. 1. Climate. Climate is the most important factor as it affects weathering of rock, nature of vegetation and the moisture in the soil. 2. Parent rock. Parent rock or the original rock, its characteristics and quality is also responsible for the type and quality of soil. For example, shales make clayey soil while sandstones contribute sand grains. 3. Rate. Rate of soil formation mostly depends on frequent temperature changes and precipitation. 4. Time. Time factor is essential both for soil formation and its use. 5. Relief, altitude, slope and natural agents of transportation and deposition like rivers and vines also affect soil formation. Depending on the origin of soil and their evolution, soils are classified into two main groups: residual and transported soils. For example, red and black soils in Deccan Plateau are residual soils, whereas the alluvial soils of Ganga Valley are transported soils. 6. Humus. Flora, fauna and microorganisms in soil affect humus formation and give it a black or grey color. Do you know? A square meter of fertile soil contains over 1 million soil animals, many too tiny to be seen with the naked eye. Soil as a renewable resource. Soil is a renewable resource. The process is, however, very complicated and slow. It takes anything from 400 to 1000 years for an inch of soil to form. Therefore, this renewability must be maintained in uninterrupted form. When soil is robbed of its basic properties, soil erosion occurs. Soil erosion is the degradation of soil properties by natural or human activities. To ensure that soil resources of earth remain intact, the rate of erosion must not exceed the rate of soil formation. Factors responsible for soil degradation. The factors affecting the formation of soil are 1. Soil erosion. Soil erosion is the main factor responsible for soil degradation and even its destruction. Among the factors responsible for soil erosion are deforestation, faulty agricultural practices, chemical fertilizers, and pesticides. 2. Salination. Accumulation of water on soil causes its saltiness. Irrigation canals lead to salination, thus resulting in soil degradation. 3. Deforestation. Deforestation leads to enormous loss of basic properties of soil. Overgrazing, overuse of chemical fertilizers, pesticides, landslides and floods also degrade the soils. Conservation of land and soil resources. Conservation, it means protection, preservation and efficient utilization of resources. While it is true that nature has capacity to renew land and soil resources on its own, it is very slow process spread over thousands of years. Conservation is a human practice that has to be promoted rather than allowed to run on its own. Some methods adopted for soil conservation are 1. Check land degradation. Degradation of land, as explained earlier, is directly related to destruction of soil resources. Therefore, land degradation must be controlled. 2. Mulching. Mulch means covering with straw or compost. Bare grounds are covered with layers of organic matter, sometimes even with crude fibers or any other organic matter. This prevents torrential rainfall, animals and fast winds from causing damage to soil. It helps to retain soil moisture in cold countries. Mulching is used for the germination of seeds. 3. Contour plowing. It is the cultivation of land along the contours in color to check the flow of water, which otherwise can wear away the soil. 4. Terrace farming. Terrace farming is done in hilly areas on steep slopes. Step-like terraces with flat surfaces are made to enable the fields to hold soil and water. This reduces surface runoff as well as soil erosion. 5. Agroforestry and other measures, afforestation, plugging of gullies, controlling shifting agriculture and intercropping are other means of soil conservation in intercropping, as in the case of wheat, different crops, particularly legumes like peas are grown in alternate rows and sown at different times to help the soil retain its nutrients. 6. Shelter belts. Trees are grown in rows and columns to prevent winds, running water and even grazing animals from causing damage to the soil. They check the speeding water and vine movement. Shelter belt plantation has been put to good use in coastal areas and dry regions. Water resources. Water forms the basis of life. It is a renewable natural resource. The presence of water distinguishes our Earth from other planets. The Earth is known as a watery planet because 3/4 of the Earth's surface is covered with water in oceans, seas and lakes. The Earth is about 4.6 billion years old. It is believed that for about a billion years in the beginning, there was no water on the Earth's surface. It was only when the Earth's surface was covered with water that atmosphere formed, sea box. Sources of water. After the formation of all three domains of the Earth, life was formed in primitive oceans about 3.5 billion years ago. In the Earth's history, the area under oceans has expanded and sunk several times depending on sea level. The ocean water is saline or salty. It is not fit for domestic, agricultural, and industrial purposes. The lithosphere receives water from precipitation through the process of hydrological cycle. The ocean water cycles through atmosphere and land and back again. The water that falls on the ground is fresh water and accounts for about 2.7% of all water resources on the Earth. Nearly 70% of this fresh water is found in the form of frozen ice sheets over Antarctica and glaciers on high mountains. Sources of water. There are contrary views among scientists regarding sources of the Earth's water. Astronomers consider comets, formed of gaseous clouds which hit the primitive Earth frequently, as the source of water on Earth. Geologists, on the other hand, consider volcanic eruption as the source of water on the Earth. Ever since oceans and seas were formed, they maintained a certain kind of level with respect to land. This is known as sea level. Find out how present phase of global warming is impacting the sea level. Harnessed freshwater. Human beings, land animals and plants use only freshwater. Human beings use it not only for drinking and washing but also for irrigation and industrial purposes. They build canals, dams and generate electricity with the help of falling water. There is a great demand for water due to rising population. Latitudinal variations. It is interesting to note that world's most densely populated areas also receive sufficient rain for their needs. Between 20 degree and 40 degrees latitudes in both hemispheres, evaporation exceeds precipitation. Therefore, these areas along with those of equatorial region have surplus precipitation. The areas where water is found in plenty include countries of Europe, South and Southeast Asia, and the Eastern USA. The dry areas include major parts of Central and West Asia, Central Australia, North Africa, and the Middle East. The arid region in Northern Hemisphere are Sahara, Arabian, and Gobi deserts. In the Southern Hemisphere, Atacama, Namibia, Kalahari and West Australia are also examples of arid parts of the Earth. Water quality. Water in its pure form is odorless and colorless liquid. It easily gets contaminated with hundreds of different types of wastes that affect its quality. It becomes saline but does not decompose easily. Therefore, these wastes infuse disease-causing pathogens in water and make it dangerous for human or even animal consumption. The common water-borne diseases are cholera, dysentery, typhoid, and amoebic infections. Water pollution is a major pollution today. It is responsible for water scarcity. Besides, there are also problems of taking piped water to far-flung and scattered rural areas. In India, only 29% of homes rural areas get water. Even in urban areas, only 65% of homes get water. Worldwide, less than 20% people in developing countries have access to clean drinking water. There is water shortage in many regions of the world on account of pollution and regional variations. Many parts of Africa, West Asia, South Asia, West USA, Northwest Mexico, South America and entire Australia are facing water shortage. Conservation of water resources. Water can be conserved and its quality improved at less expense than any other resource. Some of the important purification and quality improvement techniques are 1. Removing impurities. Any odor or color in water is a sign of an impurity. Depending on the type of impurity, these can be removed by filtration, distillation, boiling, treatment, and recycling. Some of the common water contaminants are lead, salt, iron, and hydrocarbons. 1. Filtration. In this process, water is passed through a screen like cloth, sand, charcoal, or even a specially made filtering device to remove suspended particles. Mostly insoluble and hard impurities can be removed in this process. 2. Distillation. This process involves boiling of the water and condensing pure steam, which they can be reused. This method is very effective but expensive. Many pesticides which are not biodegradable can be removed in this way. Distillation is also used for desalination of pond or sea water. Distilled water is mostly used in hospitals. 3. Boiling. Boiling of drinking water supplied by pipes is recommended for every household. It is also the most common method, as boiling kills parasites and bacteria. 4. Treatment. Water can be disinfected through treatment. Chlorination is a common way of disinfecting drinking water. Chlorine is also used in swimming pools, ponds, and water tanks. Activity. States of water. Water on Earth is found in three states: solid, liquid, and gaseous. While in liquid form, most of the Earth's water is saline. In gaseous and solid forms, water is almost in its pure state. Now answer the questions below. 1. Describe the three states of water, giving examples. 2. What happens to salinity during evaporation? 3. Observe the picture and describe the process of making salt from ocean water. 5. Recycling. Recycling is the established process of purifying waste water discharged by industries. Though recycling generally refers to reuse of resources, the process also involves purification. 2. Recharge of underground water. Today, rainwater harvesting and check dams are used to recharge and enhance the underground water table. It is the most effective method of meeting water needs and preventing water shortages in a monsoon country like India. 3. Other methods. All the above mentioned five processes involve purification, but conservation is more than purification. It means protection, preservation, and efficient utilization of water resources. Some of the important conservation techniques are 1. Improving vegetation cover by planting trees, grass, or even bushes to check surface water runoff. 2. Preventing pollution by taking adequate steps to prevent contamination of water. 3. Making legislations like banning pesticides in agriculture and using efficient means of irrigation like sprinkler irrigation. Land, soil, and water are interrelated in terms of their resource value. There can be no soil without water and rocks, as these are essential components of land needed for soil formation. This interrelationship enhances the resource value. Keywords: land use pattern, use of land and its proportion under particular use distributed over an area. Pathogens: disease-causing microorganisms. Saline water, salty water, water in oceans. Distillation: boiling of water and condensing the steam. Recycling: use of resources over and over again. Let's revise. Continuous review. Land, soil, and water are important natural resources. Land is an important natural resource, as we live on it and obtain most of our needs from it. We use land for different purposes like cultivation, grazing, mining, setting up of industries, settlements, and so on. Soil is formed by mechanical, chemical and biological processes. Water is a renewable natural resource. The total quantity of water on Earth is fixed, but its distribution is controlled by the water cycle. Depending on the type of impurity, water impurities can be removed by filtration, distillation, boiling, treatment, and recycling.
Like, share, and subscribe.